Good morning, children. Today we are going to look into the exercise of Rikki Tikki and Nag. So let us all take page number 21. Write T for true and F for false sentences. So let's read the sentence. Rikki Tikki wanted to kill Chuchundra. Is it true or false? If it's true, you can write T. If it's false, then you can write F. So let's see the correct answer for the same. The first answer will be false. Second, Nag and Nagaina were whispering in Teddy's bedroom. Is it true or false? So the correct answer is, it's false. Let's see the third one. Nagaina had laid eggs in the cabbage patch. Is it true or false? So it's a false statement. So you have to write F. Now let's see fourth one. Nag was coiled around the bath. Is it true or false? The answer is false. Fifth one. Rikki Tikki bit Nag's head. It's a true statement. So you have to write T. Sixth one, the big man shot Nag. The correct answer is true. Now let's move on to the question answer of the same. Read this answer and answer the following questions. Let's see a line taken from the story. But are you sure that there is anything to be gained by killing the people? So here the question is, who said these words and to whom? Answer is, Nag said these words to Nagaina. Let's see the next one. What does the hesitation of the speaker to kill people tell us about the speaker? His hesitation tells us that he was not sure if it was necessary to kill the people in house, it was the mongoose that was their enemy. So he felt not the people living in the bungalow. Let's see the second line taken from the story. And if he fights, oh Rikki. Who said these words? Rikki Tikki, the mongoose, said these words to himself. Let's see, who is he? He is a Nag, a big cobra. Let's see the next one. What does the speaker mean by O Rikki? The speaker means that Nag will fight very fiercely and is so powerful that he may be able to kill Rikki Tikki in a fight. So now let's move on to the section B of this question answer. Let's see the first question. What did Rikki Tikki hear when he was in the garden with Chuchundra? The answer is, Rikki Tikki heard a very faint scratching sound in the garden. A noise as faint as a wasp walking on a window pane. It was the sound of the dry scratch of the snake's scale on brick work. Let's see the next one. What instruction did Nagaina give Nag about killing the big man? Nagaina instructed Nag that he should go in quietly and remember to bite the big man first. When he had done that, he should come out and tell her. Why did Nagaina want the house to be empty? Nagaina wanted the big house empty because when there were no people in the bungalow, the mongoose would also go away and they would be king and queen of the garden. She wanted this because her eggs in the melon bed were ready to hatch and her children would need more room and quiet. So let's move on to the next question. How did Rikki Tikki attack Nag? Rikki Tikki watched Nag as the cobra drank from the water jar and waited till he fell asleep. Then he jumped and bit him on the head just above the hood. He used all his strength to hold down the head. Let's see the fifth question. Why did Rikki Tikki feel dizzy when he was fighting Nag? He felt dizzy because he was battered to and fro like a rat being shaken by a dog, back and forth on the floor, up and down and around in great circles. So let us look into the reader. Now we have the other activity. It's think and answer. Let's see the question for the same. Why do you think Nag was trying to avoid killing Rikki Tikki? Nag was trying to avoid killing Rikki Tikki as he knew it would not be an easy fight and he may get badly hurt. In fact, the mongoose was strong enough to kill him. A snake and a mongoose are natural enemies. Who was more cunning, Nag or Nagaina, and why? Nagaina was more cunning than Nag. It is she who explains to him why the people in the house had to be killed. And she wanted safety for her children. And for that, the mongoose had to be got rid of, and the only way to do that was to kill the people. She gives him instructions on their entire plan. She tells him that he should bite the big man first and then they would hunt for the mongoose together. Let's see the third one. Do you think Rikki Tikki was brave? Give evidence from the story to support your answer. Rikki Tikki was very brave. Even though he was battered badly as a Nag shook him like a rat shaken by a dog, up and down and around in great circles, he still held on to the snake's head. His eyes were red, but he held on even as his body was got whipped over the floor. Let us look into the next exercise, values and life skills. In the story, Rikki Tikki feels that he is part of Teddy's family so much so that he risks his life to save them from Nag. Discuss with your family members why you think it is important for a family to be together. So for this, children, write the answers in your English notebook and do send us the picture of the same. So do it as a homework. Now, let's move on to the next exercise. It's colloquial language. So what is a colloquial language? Writers often use colloquial language for easy reading. That's a word or a phrase is used in an informal language. Like you can see the example. Look at this sentence from the story. The little chap has saved our lives now. So chap is a colloquial word for a person. So it's a informal language used. So now match the formal word phrase with its colloquial form. So here we have to match the following, the formal word or phrase with the colloquial form. So let's see the first one, a talkative person. The correct answer for this will be chatterbox. Second, lazy. Answer for this will be couch potato. Third one, grandmother. The answer is gran. Fourth one, got to. The answer is gotta. Fifth one, a child. It's kid. And sixth one, mother. It's mom. Okay, so hope you all have done this. So we will meet up in the next class. Till then, bye.